Your clothing item is complete. The modeling, textures, and rigging work is all there. In this video, we'll go over bringing your item into Unity and getting your item into Zepeto Studio. Before we think about touching the exporter in Blender, we need to clean up and prepare the item, mask, and armature for Unity. We have to match the transformations of the Creator Base Set object, unbind the mask, delete unnecessary armature bones, and arrange everything into a flat hierarchy. If we look at the Creator Base Set's object properties, we can see that the transforms aren't completely zeroed out, and the scale is not set to 1. This is due to a difference in scale and world axis values between Blender and FBX files. Blender uses 1 meter as its default unit, while FBX uses the centimeter as its default unit. FBX files use the y-axis as its up axis, while Blender uses the z-axis as its up axis. These differences cause the rotation and scale to change in Blender. To ensure compatibility with the established pipeline, we need to mirror these transform settings. The item should be cleared of any parent, so no parent transforms are carried over. With the item selected, go to the Object menu, go to the Parent submenu, and use the Clear and Keep Transformations option to clear the parent and keep the object in place. This option will also keep your armature modifier working. If the item's transforms are not in line with the armature's transforms, we can fix that. The easiest way to set these transformations is to use the Origin Transform tools in Object Mode. To get a clean baseline, select your item, go to the Object menu, Apply, and All Transforms. This should leave your object in place with zeroed transforms. Now, under the Options menu in the upper right of the viewport, select the option to affect only origins. These settings can also be accessed in the pullout panel on the right side of the viewport under the Tools tab. Now, use the Scale tools to reduce the item's scale to 0.01 across all axes. Using the Toolbar tool, we can use the Control key while scaling to snap scaling to one decimal place. Using the Shift key in addition to the Control key increases the snap granularity to 2 decimal places. If using the hotkey S to scale, you can simply type the desired scale amount after pressing the Scale hotkey, using Enter to confirm your scale changes. Note that you can only use the Scale tools and cannot simply change the object transforms in the Property menu. While still in Origin Transform mode, we can rotate the object 90 degrees on the X-axis. You can use the hotkey or the sidebar tool, but cannot enter it into the object properties. With the item transform set, we can move on. When Unity reads the FBX file, it will look for a static mesh object labeled mask for the mask. If it doesn't find one, the conversion process will not work properly. As it is now, the mask is a skinned mesh object. To convert it into a static mesh object, all we need to do is remove the armature modifier and unparent the mask from the armature. Select the mask in Object Mode and go to the Modifiers tab. Find the Armature modifier and click on the X to remove the modifier. Now all we need to do is unparent the mask, which we can do by going to the Object menu, then Parent, then Clear and Keep Transformations. This will unparent the mask from the armature while keeping the mask in place. The transform data should be the same as the armature's transform data. If it isn't, you may have to correct it. Maya's export process allows for exporting bones with no weight information attached to them. This lack of data gets ignored by the conversion process in Unity. In Blender, the FBX exporter will attach weight information to every exported bone, which does not get ignored in the Unity conversion process. To counter this, and to get around a bone count limit error that may pop up while exporting, we'll simply delete any bone that's not being used by the item. Select the Creator Base Set Armature and go into Edit Mode. Using the Wireframe or X-Ray View modes, select the bone sets that aren't being used by your item and delete them. With unused bones deleted, this step is done. Go back into object mode. Before moving on, we want to make sure that the three objects we want to export are all unparented from each other. We went through an unparenting step while handling the item and the mask, but it doesn't hurt to double check. We can check on the parented status of a selected object by going to the Object Properties and looking for the Relationships section. Under Parent, we want to see No Object field. If that isn't the case, use the Clear and Keep Transforms operation to unparent the selected object. To get an item into Unity, we'll export the item model, mask, and armature into an FBX file. To do this, we'll start by selecting the item, mask, and armature. In the File menu, go to Export and find the FBX option. In the File window, we'll have to change a few settings in the exporter to export our item properly. We want to check the Limit to Selected Objects checkbox so that we only export the selected item, mask, and armature. We also want to go into the Armature dropdown and uncheck Add Leaf Bones. This setting would add additional helper bones to the ends of every bone in the armature. It's not necessary and can get in the way of our bone count limit. We also don't need to export any animation, so Bake Animation can be unchecked. If you want to save these export options, we can hit the plus button next to the Operator Presets menu at the top to save a preset. Just give it a name and it will be accessible from the drop-down menu in the future. With all that done, we just need to pick a place to save the file, name it, and hit Export FBX. It'll show up in your files where you saved it. Make sure you have Unity 2020.3.9 installed, as well as an up-to-date Zepeto Studio Unity Project Files folder. You can get links to these downloads from the Zepeto Studio guide under the 3D Getting Started section. Extract the Zepeto Studio Unity Project Files zip folder to a place on your computer to work on. For Unity, it's recommended to use the Unity Hub as a launcher and Unity Project Manager. It'll keep track of any Unity scenes you have opened in the past and manage Unity Engine versions for you. Open Unity Hub. Go to the Projects tab and hit Open. Find the extracted project folder and open it from the folder above Assets. It's opened from a folder and not one specific file. With our Unity project open, we'll go through the default layout. In the middle, we have the 3D scene view. It's where a lot of the editing takes place. On the left, in this toolbar, we have the hierarchy. This hierarchy contains a list of all the content in the scene. Below that is the project toolbar. The project toolbar contains all of the files inside of the Unity project. We'll be importing our FBX files here. On the right is the inspector, where we can get the properties of the selected Unity game objects. We'll be paying attention to the inspector when we get to testing and tweaking our items. Above the scene view, we can see a tab that says Game. Clicking on it, we can see the view from the game camera, and that's what we'll see when we test our item on the dummy. For testing our item, we'll be using a specific scene. In the project panel, find the playground scene and double-click to open it. To import the FBX, start by finding the FBX file you exported from Blender in your file manager. Then, simply click and drag your file into the Unity project. Unity will take some time to load your file, and then a thumbnail should appear in your project. For organizational purposes, I recommend creating a new folder in the project for your item. You can create a folder by clicking the plus button in the upper right and selecting Folder. This will create a new folder in your project that you can rename to fit your item. I'll name my folder now. With that done, Just put the FBX file inside of the folder with a drag and drop. To continue work on our item, we'll open the folder. In the item folder, we should bring in the texture that goes along with the item. Find your texture file in your file browser. To import it, just like the FBX file, just drag it into the project scene. Your item will need a unique material assigned to it, so create a new material with that plus button. Name the material based on your item. Now, we have to change the material's shader from the default Unity material. Items in Zepeto use one of several specialized shaders designed to perform well in the Zepeto app. This shader type falls under the name Zepeto and comes pre-installed in the Zepeto Studio Unity project. To change the shader type, select the shader, go to the drop-down box underneath the material name, and find the Zepeto category. We can see a few types of shaders here. For my example item, I'll just be using the Zepeto standard shader. The Zepeto standard shader material has two slots for textures. One is for color data, and the other is for normal map data. As I just have a color map, all I have to do is drag the color texture into the color texture data slot. You'll see the material change its preview appearance to fit my texture. To assign the material to the item, first select the FBX file. Navigate to the Materials tab in the Inspector. You'll see a few slots, one for the mask's material, and another for the item that you created in Blender. From here, simply drag and drop the material into the corresponding material slot in the FBX file. Hit Apply. The preview should update to have your texture on it. With the material assigned, we can convert the item. Select the FBX file and right-click on it. In the right-click menu, go to the Zepeto Studio menu entry and select Convert to Zepeto Style. After some processing, a new file will appear with just your item in the thumbnail with the same name as your FBX file. In Unity's terms, this new object is called a prefab and is a blueprint object that Unity can store your item's data in. If the prefab isn't created through this process, there may be an error in the exported item. If this happens, in Blender, check to make sure that your item's mask is detached from the armature and has a material named Lambert on it. If your item is named Mask, this can also create errors, so rename your item if you need to. With your item prefab created, it's a good time to test your item on a Zepeto avatar. We can do this in the playground scene. With the playground scene open in Unity, hit the play button at the top middle part of the screen. The Unity editor will switch into play mode, and you can see a base avatar in the center of the window. In the hierarchy panel, select the loader component. The inspector panel will have new information. At the bottom of the inspector panel, there's a list of item types. Find the item type for your item and click on the checkbox. Now, drag the converted prefab object of your item to the object box of that item type. Your item will show up on the avatar. In the game view, you can test out four body shape types alongside the default deformation pose. If something seems amiss, now's the time to fix it. This may involve going back into Blender, correcting your item, and re-exporting to an FBX. For additional troubleshooting options, we can separate the game and scene panels to occupy space side by side by dragging the tab. This allows you to see the scene view and the game view at the same time, and can let you see errors from other angles, alternate lighting, or otherwise get a bigger picture of the scene at hand. When the item is as error-free as we can make it, we can now export it to a .zepeto file. This is the file that we'll upload onto Zepeto Studio. First, make sure you're not in play mode, as the conversion process will not work in play mode. Then, select the item prefab, right-click on the item prefab, and go to the Zepeto Studio category. Here, select Export as .zepeto. If the playground scene has changed, it'll ask you if you want to save your settings. Unity will not run the conversion if the scene has unsaved changes, so either discard the changes or save them. It'll run through a conversion process. Eventually, it'll generate your .zepeto file. Now that our .zepeto file is created, we can upload this to Zepeto Studio. Go to the Zepeto Studio website. Click the Get Started or Manage Contents button to sign in to Zepeto Studio. After logging in, you'll have access to your Zepeto Studio contents. To upload your item's .zepeto file into the studio, click the Create button. We've created an item, so select Items. We can dismiss the introductory video. Click Create Item with 3D File. For more information on guidelines for 3D items, click to see the new guide. If you're already familiar with the upload guides, close the information window. Find your item category and select it. Now we can drag and drop the Zepeto file into the box or click to browse. For dragging the file in, you can drag it from the project panel in Unity to the browser. Alternatively, you can right-click the .zepeto file in the project panel and click the Show in Explorer or Finder button to make it show up in your computer's file browser. Then we can find the file in there and drag it into the browser window. Once your item is finished uploading, it's a good time to check if your item has any errors that may have gone unnoticed. Check your item's integrity with more body size options by clicking the Body Type button. To view the item on your own avatar on your phone, click the Preview on your phone link at the bottom of the screen. You can also get different poses on your phone to make sure that your item remains intact across multiple poses. If you see anything wrong with your item, it's the time to correct it. If everything checks out, we can go about filling out the details section. Give your item a name. Pick an appropriate category. Enter in some tags for search. And give your item a price. Make sure to double-check your item's thumbnail. If your item thumbnail shows up with holes in it, it may be due to the back faces of your item not rendering. For issues like these, you'll have to correct it manually in an image manipulation program. Fill in what would be the interior spaces of your item, save it as a PNG with transparency, and upload your edited thumbnail with the Update File button. If everything checks out, we can submit the item for review by clicking on the Submit for Review button, which will hand the item over to reviewers for final checks. If you're still working out some things for your item, you can hit the Save button, which will preserve all your settings and details and not submit your item for review. Once your item is approved, you can no longer make changes, so make sure you're feeling good about what you submit. And with that, we're done! Congratulations on submitting your item to Zepeto Studio. Have fun creating!